Bless him. Bless him. Bless him. Bless him. This is one of your most powerful covenants at Resurrection House for all nations. Hallelujah. No one that goes to this church that has any spiritual sense will miss this service. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yay! Magnify his name. Exalt his name. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. We give you praise, Ancient of Days. We magnify your name, the Holy One of Israel, the God of Resurrection House for all nations. Can you throw up your hands all the way up? All the way up. All the way up. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you. Behold us today. Remember your covenant with us. Hallelujah. Let rain come down. Let miracles come down. Let doors fling open. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We celebrate this Thanksgiving morning and thank you that every blessing you have ordained for us shall come to be. Yes. Yes, if you believe, you will shout. If you receive, you will shout. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, the kingdom is for babies. Can you be a child this morning and bless your father and magnify your father and exalt your father? Stolen, your father has the power to get it back. Hallelujah. Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Glory. The glory is flowing. You better jump in. I came to this service this morning so excited in my spirit. I'm telling you, I am so excited because I'm amazed that when God will give you a word, if you pursue him, he begins to interpret the word he gave you to you. As I was praying early this morning, all these familiar scriptures started coming to me. But this time, they were not coming to me as the scriptures I knew. They're coming to me to activate what he said, which is what I'm about to tell you now. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You need to hear me clear this morning. You are no longer helpless. You can change things today. Watch. He said to me, I have two categories of children. Those that pray and pray and pray and pray and keep waiting on me and feeling helpless. But I have sons of God. I show them my covenants. And they take it and go into life and make things happen. Which one are you going to be this morning? Signed up for that second bunch. Hey, I'm about to work miracles. I'm about to open doors. I'm about to cause deliverance to happen. Hey! Hey! I'm not waiting on God. He's waiting on me. Hallelujah. Happy Thanksgiving! Amen, amen, and amen! Come on, hallelujah, 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 yeah! Yay! God bless you. You may be seated. Come on, high five somebody on your way down. Tell them happy Thanksgiving. We're about to work miracles. I don't know why y'all try. You know what's going to happen. Glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, there's some glory percolating over you. Fire. Woo! Fire. Hey! Fire! Glory! Hallelujah. Come on, do you feel the rain coming up? Watch. He just said to me, say this. I will usually say it without telling you that, but I just want you to know he just told me to say this. He said to say every, you know when the glory is moving, it has a purpose. He said to say every devil, every spirit, hanging on to you, they won't let you go. He said, I should say, demons, take flight. Ooh, the altar has spoken. He's showing us faith, how to make our destiny. We are not in the number from 3 million to 2 people. Mm-mm, we're all going. You're going to follow me. You're going to follow what I'm teaching you. You're going to do what I'm doing. We are all going. We are all entering it. Follow. Glory. Glory. Hare. Sha 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 sha. Kide be 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 be. Hallelujah. I don't think I've ever been doing service and you came my way. Put that guitar down. Come to me. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah. Take flight, devil. Pick him up. Pick him up. Hallelujah. 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 I don't know. Something is on me. I feel like. Hey! 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What happened to me cannot happen to you. For 6 years, God kept coming to me. Every December 31st, I have blessed you. And I keep looking around. I said, where is it? You said that last year. These are the people that are waiting on God. You come to the sanctuary. Glory is moving. The thunder from the altar goes forth. And here comes the imp. Well, you know, you haven't seen anything. You should have shut up. It shall be. And immediately is yours. If you're testing the water, you are bypassed. Watch. If I asked you, will God lie? Can God lie? Can God do all things? Then God said, new season. Let every devil be a liar. New season. It don't matter what your issues are. New season. New glory. That's how we're going to change every Mickey Mouse stuff Satan is doing. That's how we're going to change it. We believe. We go back into our life armed with what God said. And the demons will submit to us. Come on, say it out loud. I'm through waiting. I'm ready to move. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. This is a covenant that God gave to us. And when we keep covenant with God, things work the way they're supposed to. That's why the enemy does not want you to keep. He gives you justifications, gives you these thoughts. But if you keep covenant with God, amen, you see what people are crying and fasting and praying work effortlessly. Thank you. That's the word I needed. Effortlessly. Now watch. He said, this is your new season. I told you I was thinking something, and he screamed at me, don't think that. You're in your new season. Yeah. He's not waiting for anything to change or for there to be any manifestation. I have to receive that I'm already. Watch. That's where Thanksgiving begins.
Thanksgiving begins when you receive what he has said. Then now it's no longer words mouthing off. You are actually thanking him for what you have received. By faith. That's where Thanksgiving begins. I did not know that Thanksgiving was a weapon. As he started fathering me, showing me, okay, Lord, thank you. Bless me in this word. Help the people to receive it. Thank you for the unction, the prophetic grace. I bless them. Bless me now. In Jesus' name. I started reading scriptures that I knew. I said, wait a minute. I've been reading them with a closed face. You will discover it as I share this few minutes with you. When you go back to read them, you say, wait a minute. That's what Thanksgiving is. Behind every Thanksgiving text in this word is an action. It's an action. Watch. Even when you pray, if after you finish praying, you didn't thank God, that prayer will be stuck. But the moment you start thanking God that what you just asked for, you receive. It's like you put a supernatural rocket booster to your prayer. And it will shoot, poo! So when God says new season, this covenant is pivotal to you walking in it. He said, once a year, bring your family to the altar. Ask me for the offering you should bring to me. And appear before me and offer it. He said, then you will see through the year. Look at the testimony Prince just gave. I hope you didn't miss the nuances. You know, the never tell testimony. He did a good job, but not quite the way he told me. Because he said when the truck hydroplaned, he lost complete control. He saw the truck fly over here, hit the tree, fly over there, hit the tree, and then flipped over and jumped on the other side. Who? Resurrection House. Went to these two lanes where he was hydroplaning and where he jumped over and stopped every vehicle. He's the angel of the Lord. In this day and time where people don't even respect funeral processions, you could be in trouble. They just and keep going. That a tractor trailer, all vehicles, saw what was happening, and everybody stopped and waited. Money cannot buy it.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Watch. Let me run through quick scriptures here. The one I mention all the time, Psalm 100. Look at this. Psalm 100. Watch. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. See, David commanded it by the Holy Ghost. Amen. So that's why I enjoy resurrection. We are not the chosen frozen. We get noise. And you know it's Holy Ghost noise. We are not just shouting from the top of our throat. We are shouting from our heart.
Amen.
We can feel the quickening.
Yes. Hallelujah.
God showed me, don't you know why the people are young in your church? I said, why? He said, because my word keeps quickening them. They feel that quickening. Their spirit is energized. Their health springs back. I'm not speaking to your head. I'm prophesying to your spirit. Watch.
Yeah.
Watch. He says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. No, you notice, I get on some of you that just come to church and everybody's singing and you're just looking around. Then you're not before the Lord. You're just inside a building. His presence will not appear until you start singing. Hallelujah. You have to know that your song has a spiritual DNA. Hallelujah. I don't know what I'm saying right now, because some of you, I pray nobody dies, but this is a word for you, because you don't know what's about to happen. You have to appear before him. You must sing. Hallelujah. As soon as you sing, heaven opens and God comes down. Otherwise, you just came to a building and left. Are you before the Lord this morning? He said, come before him, his presence with singing. Watch. He says, know ye that the Lord. Now watch, to show you what he was doing with these scriptures, even though I haven't gotten to Thanksgiving. You notice, if you never appear before his presence, you don't experience that thing. You will not know that the Lord is God. You know that intellectually, but you will not sense that reality. It will not register in your own heart. Your faith will not soar. You will not be strong. It will be all in your head. He said, know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people. And the sheep. Now, look at what he did with this scripture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful. He didn't say just say thank you. He said be thankful. Hallelujah. So even when church is over, you must remain thankful. You can't say thank you in the sanctuary and be murmuring in the car. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Be thankful. And he just said to me, don't you know that most of your irritation and murmuring and complaining are demons handing you their thoughts?
Come on now. That's it. Amen.
You have to cast it down. Amen. Isn't that what the weapon says? Casting down imagination. And every high thing that exhausts itself.
Mm-hmm. Beloved, we are at the eve of Thanksgiving here in America. I wish it would become a global phenomenon where every November in every nation, Thanksgiving to God will be on the calendar. Glory to God. Here at Resurrection House, we skip Wednesday night Bible study because of that service. We encourage the people, 10 to 12, just 2 hours, come to the house of God, give thanks, and then give your offering, your seed unto the Lord in thanksgiving. And then you can go home and get into the festivities, the football, you know. For those of you outside of America, this is for you. The American handball, they're calling it football. But for the rest of you, soccer is football. Yes, but here in America, for Thanksgiving, there's these football and then the turkey, the dressing, the cranberry, collard greens, candy yams. If you don't know what that is, you're watching in a part of Africa, it's okay. We have all our own dishes over there. Amen. But Thanksgiving is the greatest holiday here in America. We come family by family before God. We thank God that churches in the Atlanta area are emulating us, and more of them are now doing Thanksgiving services. It's such a powerful force. It helps you set your year. Glory to God. God gave us this covenant to keep, you know, strategic things we do throughout the year to keep us in the supernatural flow and in the glory flow. Learn it, emulate it, even if there's no Thanksgiving Day in your country, you can have a Thanksgiving Sunday in your house. We have that. I remember when we were growing up, you know, once a year we all return, and then everybody will bring their offering, and then we'll give to my dad, and he will carry it, and we'll go to the altar as a family to give thanks unto the Lord. And then we come back and celebrate and eat and fellowship, and then we all return to our places. So we started doing that years ago, even before I came to America. Learn it. Thanksgiving is preferred by God than anything else you can offer. A heart of thanksgiving is golden. It's diamond. It's anything beyond golden, yes. Learn it. Act on it. Drive murmuring and complaining away from you. And there's no way to counter it than singing a song. Hallelujah. And sometimes the angels of God will be around you and they will be singing. I call them your songs of deliverance, according to Psalm 32. Sing them out. Don't hum them in your head. Just sing them out. It helps you get out of the pit. It helps you lift out of the clutches of circumstance. We will be here tomorrow, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. If you're in the Atlanta area, join us. If you need more information, call 770-994-3777. We'll give you all the information. But you really don't need anything else. Jump in the car, 6605 Resurrection Way, and come to Union City, Georgia, and join the service. Your life will not remain the same. Amen. I encourage you, don't allow Satan to sink you into the depression that always comes on people, you know, during this season. You know, we're coming to the end of the year. You may feel unaccomplished. You may feel that things haven't changed. But don't sink into depression. That's the reason you stay in church, stay in Bible studies, stay in Sunday worship, stay up, and move into a new year greater than this current year. It is the year of a supernatural breakthrough, the year of new season and new glory. May God deliver it to you as you believe the word we have spoken and receive it by faith in Jesus' name. God bless you. We'll see you at Thanksgiving. Hallelujah.